Like most benthic marine invertebrates, nemerteans have planktonic larvae. In any particular location around the world, some species of nemerteans may be easier to find as planktonic larvae than as benthic adults. This is especially true of parts of the world where there is not much in the way of intertidal zone. So much of the collecting of adults has to be done either by dredging or by scuba diving. Planktonic larvae may be difficult to identify because all of the species descriptions are based on the internal or external anatomy of adults. But larvae can be matched to adults based on DNA sequence data. In this video, I will demonstrate how to collect, examine, and preserve nemertean larvae for DNA barcoding. To collect nemertean larvae, you will need a plankton net with a mesh size of about 100 to 150 or 200 micron. Gently lower the net in the water and drag it slowly through the water. You can do this by pacing up and down a dock or by towing the net behind a kayak or a boat. It may be useful to have a little weight attached to the mouth of the net to help it sink down. If you're using a motorboat, be sure to go as slowly as is possible, going in and out of gear. Now we're pulling up the net. Raise it out of the water and dip it in a few times to rinse the plankton into the cod end. Unscrew the cod end or unclip it and pour the sample into a jar. You can place the sample in a cooler or a bucket to take it back to the lab. You may want to dilute dense samples, and in general, you want to keep the sample cold and sort it within the next few hours so that the animals remain alive. To sort the plankton sample, you will want a bowl, a turkey baster, a glass pipette, some small dishes, and some filtered seawater. Use a turkey baster to move a small amount of your sample into the bowl. You don't want too much, maybe 1 or 2 centimeters deep, and examine it under the dissecting microscope. Once you find your larva, use a glass pipette and separate it into a small dish with filtered seawater. Keep sorting the sample, separating interesting specimens until you're done with it. Once you've finished sorting your sample, you're ready to look at some of your selected specimens. This is the iconic nemertean larva called the pilidium. It looks like a hat with ear flaps. The ear flaps are called the lappets. There's also these two lobes. You can see a ciliated band spanning the lobes and lappets, an apical tuft at the anterior end, and inside the pilidium you can see its gut, which is this dark brown area, and a little juvenile worm riding around. Nemertean larvae range in size from about 100 microns to over a millimeter, but most of them are fairly small, so you will need to make a slight prep and examine each larva under the compound microscope. You're going to use a glass slide and pipette the larva onto the slide in a small drop of seawater. And then you will take a cover slip and use a piece of modeling clay to create little feet to support the cover slip over the slide so you don't squish your specimen. And gently lower the cover slip onto the slide. You may need to compress the specimen just a little bit to trap it and prevent it from swimming. For this, you will put the slide back into the microscope and gently compress the clay at the corners while looking at it through the microscope to make sure you don't damage the specimen. Now you're ready to examine it under the compound microscope. Note the shape, color, and developmental stage of the larva, and, if at all possible, photograph it. Paridia come in many different shapes. Some look like hats or helmets. Others look like socks. Most Paridia are planktotrophic, but about 20 species are lacertotrophic. They have very much reduced larvae that superficially resemble cnidarian planula larvae or trochophore larvae of some spiralians like annelids. Pylidium larva is only found in one clade of nemerteans called the Pylidiophora. Other groups, including Hoponemertea and Paleonemertea, have the so-called planudiform larvae, which essentially are little planktonic juveniles. Once you have looked at the live larva and photographed it, you'll want to preserve this individual for DNA barcoding. For this, you'll want to use a pair of forceps to carefully lift the cover slip off the larva, open a tube, and fill it with preservative, such as 95% ethanol, and then pipette your larva with as little water as possible into that tube. So pipette it up and down to make sure that the larva gets into the tube for sure. And then check to see that the larva is in the tube. You may want to examine the tube under the dissecting microscope just to verify that the larva is really in it. And close the tube and label it in such a way that you can match the specimen to the photographs.